how to draw quadrilateral. Drawing triangle was easy because there are only three sides. We can draw one side and just make mark of intersection point of other two sides. But for quadrilateral, it will be difficult. Let's start with the very basic figure of quadrilateral, that is square. To draw square is really, really difficult for someone, but not for us, because we know the method and we know the reason why we are doing this. So for that, what we will do? Probably here you will not see the diagram properly, but on other screen you will see that perfectly. You can get idea what I am doing here by seeing on that part. So here we will draw one line, but of what size? Okay, suppose we need a rectangle, square. We need a square of 1 foot length, whose side length is 1 foot. So we will take that length here, draw that much side. So this is 1 foot. Now this is not the side of square, this is the length of side of square which we want to draw. Now the properties of square, if you know, then you can draw the square perfectly. Okay, now what we will do for square? For square we will draw the side length which is required. This will not be exact side, this is just length which we will measure for square. So for this we will draw a circle around this. So we will make half of that. Suppose this is a diameter, and let's make half of that and take this distance as radius. So this is the radius of circle. Then draw the circle around this line. So if you see, that line will divide circle in two semicircles. So this will be one semicircle and this will be the another semicircle. Now we have to draw perpendicular line, perpendicular bisector line to this part, so that we can get exact opposite two points, so that their distance will be equal on both sides. Okay, so for that we have to draw end points. We have to draw intersection arcs from both end points, and for that we have seen how to draw perpendicular bisector. So let's take nails here, draw one arc here of same length, and for here also do the same thing. Remember, we have to take the exact same distance here also and here also. Now the two points we will get for intersection, that we will connect exactly. So let me connect that first. So this is the part which we will join, and we will get here perpendicular bisector for the diameter inside a circle. Okay, now what we have to do, that we have now four points on the circle. Here one point of the perpendicular bisector, here is one point of perpendicular bisector which is intersected with circle. Then here are two points which we have get from diameter, which we can get from diameter. We have four such points. Now from these four points, if we join this, we will get square, but this square will not be of length, a side length of the diameter. The diameter will be there diagonal, not the side. So to get the square of this side length, we have to do some more construction. What we will do, we have these four points. From each point we will draw the same size of circles, same size of circle which we have drawn here. We will do the same thing here. So from here we will draw one circle like this. Instead of drawing circle, I am just drawing large part of circle. Or we can draw complete circle as well. If we want, we can draw complete circle. From that side also, from this point also, we can draw the perfect circle. Then from this point also we will draw the circle like this, of same size. So there will be five circles which are of same size. Okay, this circle which we have drawn in the beginning, and four circles from each of these four points. So these four circles, from this point I have to draw. So we will draw like this. And now that four circles we have drawn, that we have to remember. So one circle is here, one circle is here, one circle is here, and one circle is here. So there will be again four extra points which are outside the inner circle. like here, where the four circles are intersected with each other. So here is one point, here is one point, here is one point, and here is one point. Now, if we join all these points, you can see that each that line segment will be tangent to this square, to this circle, and that side length will be the square. That sides will form the square of the required diameter. For drawing square, it was really interesting and very lengthy method also. But at that time, in the ancient period, we don't have any protractor or any marked scale. Now let's see how to draw rectangle. For square only there was this much work. So we can say for rectangle there will be more work. But no, actually for rectangle it is easy. And now for rectangle I am making claim here only that this method I have found for rectangle. If there is any shorter method than this, then you can give that in comment section. So for rectangle, we can draw any side first, either length or breadth. So let me make this clear first. So let's draw one side. Let's say this is the one side of rectangle. Okay, this is the one side of rectangle. And now how to move further? See, we can draw one circle just like for square. We will draw this circle around this, taking the diameter as that side length. So we will make the half of that line. So this is the length of line. We will make half of that. So this will be the radius of that circle. So we will take that two nails. I don't have nails right now, so I am taking pens. So take that two nails and draw the circle. Draw the circle around that line, assuming that line as a diameter. We will draw the circle. Okay, we will draw the circle. Don't worry. Okay, now by drawing that circle, what we can do? You have to get the perpendicular line, because the other two sides are perpendicular to that. We cannot draw perpendicular line directly there, but we can do one thing, that we can draw perpendicular bisector of this line, right? So after drawing perpendicular bisector, how to draw that? Take these two as end point. From this part, make two arcs here and here. From this end point, make two arcs here and here, and join that, we will get a perpendicular bisector. Now on that perpendicular bisector, we have here center, right? This is the center, and from that center, we will take the distance of second side. So let's take the second side is of this length, small length let's take. This is the length, and make the arc on this side. On any side we can do, either that side or this side. So let's make arc here, and now on this arc, again from this arc we have to draw perpendicular bisector, so that we can get the other side which is parallel to the diameter. So to do that, we will take again this distance, that is the side length which is smaller or which is we have taken here, we will take that and make it double. Okay, or instead of making double, we can just do like this, make another arc here. Now we have center and the second arc. If we get the perpendicular bisector, then that perpendicular bisector will go through this point. Okay, so we will do that process. We have two points here and here. From both these points, we will draw arc. We will draw two arcs, one on this side, one on this side. From this point also, we will do the same thing of drawing arcs. And again, the points we have get, we will join that points, and we have now two sides of rectangle. One side length is fixed, for other part we have not fixed it the side length, but that is easy. How? Because we know the side length of we have the side length of one side, so using that we can get that. We know this point is center of this side, and this point will be center of this side. Whatever this side is, that will be the center, and both of these will be equal. So let's take this radius as measure, because it is half of that side. Then keep it here, make an arc here also, and the point we have intersected here, we will connect that to the one end point of diameter, and we have now here the third side of rectangle. The same distance we will take to the other side also. Make their arc and join this end point of diameter with this arc which is connected to this parallel side. And now these four sides, one side of diameter, one side of parallel line and two sides which we have connected will form our required rectangle. So this is the way for rectangle. Now the question is how to draw another figures. Okay, now frankly speaking, for other figures like pentagon or septagons which have five sides or seven sides, that I don't know how to draw that, how the ancient people draw that, but we can see how we can draw hexagons or octagons, that we can see. Before that, again come to quadrilaterals. In quadrilaterals there are not only these two types of quadrilaterals, we have rhombus, parallelogram. Rhombus we have seen while doing angle bisector thing, right? In angle bisector we have seen how to draw rhombus. We can get that four points, one is for that angle, two points on that two rays, and using the arcs we can get the four point, and after joining that we will get the rhombus. Now for parallelogram, what we will do, let's see again the rhombus part. Suppose this is one side and this is second side. So in rhombus we draw one arc here and one arc here. Both these arcs are of same side, so it is creating rhombus. Now instead of taking both these sides as same, both these arcs as same distance, let's take this smaller one here and larger one here. Now we have one arc here and one larger arc here. Oh, not arc, the side length. Now again we will take this distance, this smaller distance, and keep the fixed point here and draw arc here like this. Let's suppose this is a nail. Let's take this is a nail and we will make the same distance arc here as well, because the opposite sides of parallelogram are equal, so we will make arc here. Now we will take the distance of second side, which is the longer one, and from this point we will do the same arc thing, and we have the four points, 1, 2, 3, and 4. We will connect these four points together to form a quadrilateral, and we have now our required parallelogram. In this way we can draw any shape. We can draw trapeziums or kite shapes using the arcs only, and it is really simple. You can try it on your own. I am not giving each and every. Now for hexagon it is really easy, because hexagon is created by combining equilateral triangle. Here this first what I have drawn here. Okay. For octagon we will draw one line. Now this line is not of side length. This line is the diagonal of that